particle is on diffusion through variable cross-section area per cylinder. My name is Rishita. Shravani will start.
My name is Shravani. The question is, sublimation of a 20 centimeter long naphthalene cylinder of mass 10 grams occurs in a large volume of air in a room at a temperature of 45 degrees Celsius and 1 atmosphere pressure. The vapor diffuses through a small stagnant film of thickness 3 millimeters surrounding the cylinder. The air beyond the film is well mixed. Calculate the time required for sublimation of half of the naphthalene. It is assumed that loss of mass because of sublimation from the flat ends may be neglected. The given values are DAB equals to 6.92 into 10 power minus 6 meter square per second. The density is 1140 kg per meter cube and the sublimation pressure is 0.8654 mm of Hg. Now coming to the theory behind this problem, diffusion through variable cross-section area for cylinder. In many mass transfer operations, the area where the diffusion occurs may vary with time. If the diffusion occurs through a varying cross-sectional area, a specified form of equation for diffusion through a stagnant gas is used. During the diffusion through a variable cross-sectional area, Na, which is equals to Na bar by A, will not be constant since it depends on the area which is varying, where Na bar is the mole flux, which is constant at steady state.
My name is Chitrakshi Gandhi. And so the data given for this problem is as follows. A is naphthalene and B is air. Length of cylinder L is equal to 20 centimeter. Mass of naphthalene gas cylinder is 10 gram or 10 to the power minus 2 kg. Temperature of the room is 45 degrees Celsius or 318.15 Kelvin. Room pressure is equal to 1 atm or 101.325 kilopascal. Thickness of stagnant film is equal to 3 millimeter or 3 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. Diffusivity DAB is equal to 6.92 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square per second. Density is equal to 1140 kg per meter cube. The sublimation pressure is given as 0.8654 mmHg, which is equal to 0.1154 kilopascal. Gas constant R is equal to 8.314 kilopascal meter cube per kilomole Kelvin. Volume of the cylinder is mass of cylinder upon density, which is equal to 8.7719 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square. Molecular weight of A, naphthalene, is equal to 128 kg per kg mole. For initial radius of cylinder, RC1, volume of cylinder is equal to pi RC1 square into L, which gives RC1 is equal to 3.737 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. At final condition, after half of the cylinder is sublimed, volume of cylinder 1 by 2V is equal to pi into RC2 square into L, which gives RC2 is equal to 2.643 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. The formula is time required for the sublimation of half of the naphthalene gas, that is from RC1 to RC2 is T1 minus T0 is equal to 1 by 2 RC1 square ln RC1 plus alpha upon RC1 minus RC2 square ln RC2 plus alpha upon RC2 plus alpha by 2 RC1 minus RC2 minus alpha ln RC1 plus alpha upon RC2 plus alpha divided by DAB into P upon RT into MA upon rho A into ln P upon P minus PAS.
The derivation for this problem starts from the relationship between flux into surface area is constant. Here we consider the sublimation of cylinder which has a length of L and radius RC. The vapor diffuses through a stagnant film of air of thickness alpha surrounding the cylinder, and the air beyond the film is well mixed. Imagine a thin shell of inner radius R and thickness delta R. This is a binary system of species A and B, where A is diffusing and B is non-diffusing. we get an expression for time, that is t minus t naught is equals to half of RC1 square ln of RC1 plus alpha by RC1 minus RC2 square ln of RC2 plus alpha by RC2 plus alpha by 2 RC1 minus RC2 minus alpha ln RC1 plus alpha by RC2 plus alpha whole divided by DAB P by RT MA by rho ln of P minus PAS. Ln of P by P minus PAS.
My name is Yashwant. From the derivations, the calculations are pretty much self-explanatory. Subjecting to substitute the relevant terms, RC1 being 3.737 into 10 power minus 3 meters, RC2 being 2.643 into 10 power minus 3 meters, and atmospheric pressure is 101.325 kilopascals. After that, we'll compute the numerator, thereby eliminating the difficulty in calculation. Now, afterwards, we calculate numerator turns out to be 2.3095 into 10 power minus 6 meters square. And for the computing denominator, we substitute DAB 6.92 into 10 power minus 6 meters square per second. Atmospheric pressure, which is 101.325 kilopascals. Molecular mass of naphthalene is 128 kg per kg mole. Atmospheric pressure 101.325 kilopascals. Ideal gas constant is 8.314 kilopascal meter cube per kg moles into Kelvin. Temperature, which was initially 45 degrees, converting into Kelvin is 318.15 kelvins. Density is 1140 kg per meter cube. After cancelling the relevant units, the denominator turns out to be 3.3917 into 10 power minus 11 meter square per second. After computing both numerator and denominator, we divide both of them, which turns out to be 68092.697 seconds. We then divide this time with 3600 to calculate in hours, which is 18.9146 hours.
My name is Ahmed Shahabi. I'm here to tell the summary for this problem. And the solution here obtained are only of academic interest, because a large body of gas in which there are no convection currents is unlikely to be found in practice. However, the solution developed here for this problem actually represent a special case of the more common situations involving both molecular diffusion and conductive mass transfer. And the final statement is the time required for the sublimation of half of naphthalene is 18.9146 hours in a 20 centimeter long cylinder. This problem is a special case of both molecular diffusion and conductive mass transfer.
A question is, a vertical glass tube of 1 centimeter in diameter is filled with liquid acetone to a depth of 5 cm from the top opening. After 4 hours of operation at the temperature of 403 Kelvin and a total pressure of 1 atmosphere, the level is dropped by 2 mm. The density of the given liquid is 790 kg per meter cube and vapor pressure is 288 mm of Hg under given conditions. Neglecting the counter diffusion of air to replace the liquid, calculate the diffusivity of acetone in air. Molecular weight of acetone is 58 kg per kilomole. The theory behind this problem is also known as Stefan experiment, and the conditions are the A is diffusing and the B is non-diffusing. Vapors of A are diffusing in air and we are determining the gas diffusivity. This cell is also known as Avenel cell, and this stagnant is a film of air, and the concentration of air A is tip at the tip is negligible. This given whole solution is done by Chani Roy of our group. This is a model of our and the diagram of our solution.
So in this acetone being evaporated in the air, and the surrounding air which is blowing from above is carrying away this liquid. So we can consider this problem similar to when a gas mixture A is diffusing and where B is non-diffusing. So diffusing, we can consider it as liquid acetone, and non-diffusing is air. So as we go on to the next slide. So at a steady state, we can assume that rate of evaporation of liquid equal to flux of air. So, and we will assume steady state approximation. And rho AB is the density of liquid, and DAB is the diffusivity. So, as now, next slide. This is the given data. In this initial height, which is Z1, is given to be 5 cm, and further it is dropped by 2 mm. So, the final height becomes 0.052 meter. And the density of liquid is given us as 790 kg per meter cube. And vapor pressure of acetone is given as 288 mm of Hg. Now, we will substitute all these values in our formula. And for calculating the flux, we need ln of PBLM. So, in order to calculate this, we will first need to calculate PB1 and PB2. Then we will use those values and calculate PB ln. So here PA1 is given as 288 mm of Hg, and we will convert all these values in kilopascal, as we put our values in kilopascal in that formula. And PA2 is zero, as in the atmosphere there we assume only air is present, and this liquid acetone, which is formed just above the test tube, is being carried away by the air. So and it is given that total pressure is atmospheric pressure, which is 101.325 Kelvin, and PA1 is calculated to be 38.39 kilo. So we will subtract pressure of acetone from total pressure, then we will get the PB1, which comes out to be 62.93 kilopascal, and PB2 will be atmospheric pressure only, as we neglect the liquid acetone present there, which is 101.325 kilopascal. Now temperature is given as 403 Kelvin, and molecular weight is given as 58 kg per kg mole. So here we calculate PBLM, which comes out to be 80.61 kilopascal, and time is given 4 hours. So we will convert this hours into second, which comes to be 1440 seconds. Now this is our formula. DAB is equal to 1 by T rho A by MA, Z2 square minus Z1 square by 2, RT by P, ln of PBLM divided by PA1 minus PA2. So on substituting these values, we get the DAB of the mixture as 6.69894 to multiplied by 10 to the power minus 6 meter square per second, which is the unit of diffusivity. So the final diffusivity of acetone comes out to be 6.6984 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square per second. So this was the complete solution of our problem. Thank you.
I am MD Murtaza. The problem is based on steady state diffusion of A through non-diffusing B. Team members which are going to solve the problem. First one is myself, MD Murtaza from section B.
Myself, Arpit Bansal from section A.
Myself, Pawanlal from section A.
Myself, Kaustub from section A.
Myself, Jeev Tanavaraj from section A.
The here oxygen is diffusing through the two plates which are at 2 mm distance from each other. The partial pressure on either side of the plane are given as 13,000 Pascal and 6,500 Pascals. The data are diffusivity of oxygen through carbon monoxide is 1.87 into 10 power minus 5. And here we have to calculate the rate of diffusion of oxygen in kilomoles through each square meter of the two plane.
So as we come to the theory behind this problem, when we consider diffusion between two substances A and B, in which A is diffusive and B is non-diffusing, So we consider only the molar convective flux of A, and the molar convective flux of B we consider as zero, and the flux equation simply becomes as given below. The molar convective flux of A is dAB, that is diffusivity, into total pressure into the partial pressure difference at both sides, and divided by RTZ into logarithmic mean pressure.
From the given question, we can take the data as the diffusivity of oxygen in carbon monoxide is 1.87 into 10 power minus 5 meter square per second, and total pressure is equal to 10 power 5 pascals, and absolute temperature is 273 kelvins. The distance between two planes is 0.002 meters. The partial pressure of oxygen on one side is 13,000 newton per meter square, and the partial pressure of oxygen on either side is 6500 newton per meter square. The formula that we are going to use in this problem is the molar convective flux of A is diffusivity of A into B into pressure total into the difference of PA1 and PA2 by RTZ PBLM, that is logarithmic mean pressure.
As we know, the total pressure will be the sum of the partial pressures of the diffusing component and the non-diffusing component. So PB1 plus PA1 equals to P total. And from that, we will find the PB1, that is the partial pressure of the non-diffusing component, equals to the total pressure minus PA1, which is 10 raised to power 5 minus 13,000, which we get 87,000 pascals. Similarly, on the other side of the plate, the total pressure will be constant and will be the sum of the partial pressures of the diffusing and the non-diffusing components. So that is PB2 plus PA2 equals to P total. And from that, we will find the partial pressure of the non-diffusing component. PB2 equals to, 10 raised to 5 minus 6500, which is 93,500 pascals. So the logarithmic mean pressure of the non-diffusing component PB will be PBLM equals to PB2 minus PB1 divided by ln PB2 upon PB1. And upon substituting the values we got earlier, we will get the logarithmic mean pressure as 90,200 pascals. And now we will substitute all the values we have in the formula, which is Na equals to diffusivity of A in B into P total into difference of the partial pressures of A on the both sides of the plane, divided by R into temperature into the length of the plane into the log mean pressure of the non-diffusing component. So that is 1.87 into 10 raised to power minus 5 meter square per second into 10 raised to power 5 meter per meter square, which is pascal, into 13,000 minus 6500 newton per meter square, that is pascals again, divided by 8.3 per mole Kelvin into 273 Kelvin into 0.002 meters into 90,200 newton per meter square, which is pascals. And upon calculating, we get 2.97 into 10 raised to power minus 5 kilomole per meter square second. This unit we get from tallying all the units above.
As we reach to the final part, I would like to say the rate of diffusion of oxygen through each square meter of two planes is given as molar convective flux by into area, and given as like area is 1 meter square, and N is given by 2.97 into 10 to the power of 5 kilomole per meter square second into 1 meter square, and it is given by 2.97 into 10 to the power of minus 5 kilomole per second.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Well, in this revision numericals, we have seen a numerical on diffusion through variable surface area for cylinders, presented well by Rishita, Shravani, Ahmed Shahabi, Yashwant and Chitrakshi Gandhi. I appreciate their sincere efforts. They gave their best. And then we have seen a numerical on gas diffusivity, which was presented by Sri Krishna Phanish, Indresh Bharatwaj, Abdul Khalik, and Jagadish Chandani Rai. I appreciate their efforts, but I couldn't see their contribution from other members in the video. However, they had done a good job. We have seen a numerical on steady state diffusion of A through non-diffusing B, presented by Murtaza's team, which had Arpit Bansal, Pavan Lal, Kaustav Sonawane, Pranav Raj. All of them have contributed in the video. I appreciate their sincere efforts. I will meet you in the next lecture with another set of assignment numericals solved by our beloved students. Bye bye.